Dear students, now we are going to discuss the remaining part of dihybrid cross. Dihybrid cross, genotypic ratio. Dihybrid cross, genotypic ratio. Okay, so multiply monohybrid cross genotypic ratio 1:2, 2:1 multiplied with 1:2, 2:1. 1:2, 2:1 is a monohybrid genotypic ratio. So if monohybrid genotypic ratio is multiplied 1:2, 2:1 multiplied with 1:2, 2:1, we'll get 1:1, 1. 1:2, 2. 1:1, 1. This one completed. Next, this one. 2:1, 1. Sorry. 2:1, 2. Next, 2:2, 4. Next, 2:1, 2. Next, this one, 1:2, 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times. What are they? How to get a 1:2:1, 1:2:4, 1:2:1. So now take genotypes here one by one. Yesterday we discussed YYRR. What about the probability of this one out of 16 F2 plants? Okay, out of all genotypes, what about its number? So how to get it? So here, what about the number of kinds of alleles of this gene? Initially, I'm taking simple calculation. The gene 1, gene 2. Gene 1 is with one kind of allele. Gene 2 also with one kind of allele. So the probability of 1 with the other one, 1:1. So here, number of kinds of alleles, 1 only. The number of kinds of alleles of R concerned, 1:1. So its probability is 1/16. Okay, so first one completed. 1/16. Its number is 1/16. So simply 1:1. The probability of number of kinds of alleles of one gene multiplied with number of kinds of alleles of second gene, you'll get the probability of or total number of that genotype in the total genotypes. Okay, its number, the number of that one, second one, YYRR. So what about the number of kinds of alleles of Y gene? 2. Here, 1. 2:1. So 2:1. So its probability is 2 by 16. So second one completed. Okay, next, third one. Third one is small r. Capital r. So 1 into 1. One kind. So its probability is 1 by 16. So 1:2:1 completed. Next. Fourth one. 2 given. Right? Now take capital Y. Take 1 in heterozygous condition. We'll get its probability. That is 2. Capital R, small r. So 1 into 2. 2 by 16. Okay, right. Next, fifth one. Given one is 4 is given. Means both the genes must be in heterozygous condition. So take Y, capital R, small r. So 2 into 2. 4 by 16. Sixth one, 2 given. Means 1 must be in heterozygous condition. The other one must be in homozygous condition. So small y, capital R, 1 into 2, 2 by 16. This one completed. Next one. 1 means both must be in homozygous condition. Seventh one. You can take seventh one. Capital Y, small r, 1 into 1. Its probability is 1 by 16. Eighth one. This one is 2. So 1 must be heterozygous and the other is a homozygous. No repetition. Okay. So 2 into 1. Its probability is 2 by 16. Ninth one, 1. One means definitely both the genes must be in homozygous condition. Go for small r, 1 into 1, 1 by 16. So 1:2:1:2:2:4:2:2:1:2:1. 1:2:1:2:1. So that is about probabilities of individual probabilities of each and every kind of genotype. Total number of kinds of genotypes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So out of total number of 16 genotypes, not kinds, the probability of all these things, 1:2:1:2:4:2:1:2:1. Right? So how to get its probability? Simply calculate total number of out of 16 plants, how many plants are having capital Y. Okay? Multiplied with total number of F2 plants with capital R. You will get the probability of that one. Simply, it is 1/4 × 1/4. 1/4 means it's a probability. The probability of capital Y overall out of 16, how many are there? 4 by 16. So here it is 1/4 multiplied with 1/4. So 1 by 16. So what about in this case? Here I'm taking first one. What about the probability of capital Y? That is 4 by 16, means 1 by 4. And capital R also 4 by 16, its probability is 1 by 4. If these two are multiplied, we'll get the probability of that one. Same. Apply same rule. What about total number of F2 plants with capital Y? Its probability. What about the probability of this one? The probability of that one is 8 by 16. 2 by 4. Okay, for example, here I'm taking capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. So the probability of capital Y, small y multiplied with capital R, small r. What about the probability of this one? The probability of capital Y, small y is 8 by 16 is equal to simplify it. Okay, so if it is simplified, sorry, 2 by 4. This one also 2 by 4. So 2 by 4 into 2 by 4, 4 by 16. So that is the way to decide the number of individual genotypes out of 16 genotypes. Okay, right? Is it clear? Next, wait. Now, what about the kinds of genotypes for each kind of phenotype? For each kind of phenotype, what about the number of kinds of genotypes? That is very, very important. So, kinds of genotypes. Kinds of genotypes for each kind of phenotype. Simply, for each kind of phenotype, what about the number of kinds of genotypes? So here, total number of kinds of phenotypes. How many kinds of phenotypes and how many kinds of genotypes? 4 kinds of phenotypes and number of kinds of genotypes, 9. Here the question is, what about the number of kinds of genotypes for? Okay, so yellow round. This is a one kind of phenotype. And what about genotypes for this one? How many kinds? 1, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R. That is one kind. Next, capital Y, small y, capital R, second kind. Next, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Next, capital Y, small y, capital R. Wait. Okay, right, repeat it, wait. Capital Y, capital R, small r. No repetition. Capital Y, capital R, capital R, one kind. Second kind, third kind, yes. How many kinds? 1, 2, 3, 4. Come back. Yellow round. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. How many kinds? So total number of kinds of genotypes for this one. How many kinds? 4 kinds. 4 kinds for this one. This is very, very important. And total number, you can prepare it. 1 into 1, 1 only. 2 into 1, 2. So it's number 1, simply 1, 2, 4, 2. But kinds, how many? 4 kinds. Okay, next. Second one. Phenotypic recombinant. That is a yellow color, yellow dominant, yellow wrinkled. So what about the number of kinds of genotypes for yellow wrinkled phenotypic recombinant? So yellow dominant, so capital Y, that is one. Wrinkled, definitely that should be smaller, smaller. That is one kind. Okay, next. Capital Y, smaller, smaller. Okay, so how many kinds for this one? Only two kinds. Check it from here. Okay, not possible. One homozygous possible, one heterozygous possible for yellow. Wrinkle means both must be in homozygous condition. It's number one, one into one, one, two into one, two. So total number one plus two, three. And how many kinds here? Two kinds only. Okay, so number of kinds of genotypes for this one, two kinds only. Okay, four plus two completed. Four plus two, six completed. Next. Okay, next one. Green, round. Phenotype recombinant. Green, recessive character. Definitely, the concerned gene must be in homozygous condition. Okay, so first take green. So small y, green completed. Okay, so next round. In round, two probabilities possible. One is homozygous capital R, heterozygous capital R, small r. Okay, its probability one, its probability is two, heterozygous condition. So for this one, what about the number of kinds of genotypes for this one? Two kinds. Okay, so this is one kind of phenotype with four kinds of genotypes. This is one kind of phenotypic recombinant with two kinds of genotypes. This one is a second type. Second type of a phenotypic recombinant with two kinds of genotypes. So what about the total number of genotypes for phenotypic recombinants? Overall four kinds. Okay, next. So four plus four, eight completed. Remaining one is only one. Okay, so round it. This one is phenotypic recombinants. Okay, so here I'm writing phenotypic recombinants. Phenotypic recombinants. Definitely, they will ask you, what about the number of kinds of genotypes for phenotypic recombinants? What about the number of kinds of phenotypic recombinants? One, two. How many kinds of genotypes? Two, four. Two is to four, means one is to two. This is very, very important. Okay, next. Fourth one. This is a fourth kind of a phenotype, that is double recessive, double homozygous, double recessive. That is green wrinkled, parental type. This one parental type only. Green wrinkled. This is one kind of a phenotype with how many kinds of genotypes? This is very, very important. That is a small y. See, green. Green means that must be, gene must be in homozygous condition, recessive condition. Okay, next a small r. So how many kinds? One kind. So this is a with a one kind only, one kind of genotype. So definitely they will ask this question, out of all these phenotypes, one kind of phenotype with a one kind of genotype is this one. Okay, right. So highest number of kinds of genotypes are pertaining to yellow round, least green wrinkled. So four plus one. Okay, so here the question is one kind. Here I will give you. Here I will give you explanation for that one. One kind of phenotype with four kinds of genotypes. What is that one? That is yellow round. For this one, the answer is yellow round. Yellow round is a one kind of a phenotype or not? One kind only. How many kinds of phenotypes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is one kind of phenotype with how many kinds of genotypes? 4 kinds. Okay, so remember this one. Next, second one. One kind of phenotypic recombinant. One kind of phenotypic recombinant with 2 kinds of genotypes. 2 kinds of genotypes. Here we can take 2. What are they? These 2. Either yellow wrinkled or green round. Here I'm taking simultaneously green round. I don't want to write one more statement for that one, green round. Okay, one kind of a phenotype recombinant with 2 kinds of genotypes, either this one or this one. Both are having same number. So that's why I finished a so-called statement within one statement only. Next, third one, very, very important. One kind of phenotype with 1 kind of genotype. What is that one? That is green wrinkled. This is very, very important. One kind of a phenotype with 1 kind of a genotype. Go back. Yellow round is 1 kind of phenotype with how many kinds of genotypes? 4 kinds. Next, yellow wrinkled is 1 kind of a phenotypic recombinant with 2 kinds of genotypes. Next, third one, green round. This is a second type of a phenotypic recombinant. This one also 1 kind of a phenotypic recombinant with 2 kinds of genotypes. So in the second statement together, I wrote answer is either yellow wrinkled or green round. Okay, so last one, this is very, very important. 1 kind of phenotype with 1 kind of genotype. Definitely that is a green wrinkled. Okay, is it clear? So that is about a number of kinds of genotypes for each kind of phenotype. 9:4. Okay, right? This is very, very important. Definitely out of this box, definitely they will ask at least 1 question, minimum. Okay, right?